皆さん、こんにちは。ザムライエンジニアです。In this video, let us continue on the third module video of LU decomposition as a technique in solving simultaneous linear equation. Finding the inverse of a square matrix, let us take a look. The inverse of matrix B of a square matrix A is defined as. Okay, so let us determine how to find out the inverse of a square matrix. So let us define inverse B of a square matrix A. So we have, if that is the inverse, therefore we have A times B is equal to identity matrix. Okay. So identity matrix, because it is identity, we can do the pre-multiplication and post-multiplication, doesn't matter, because that's identity. Okay. Finding the inverse of a square matrix, how can LU decomposition be used to find the inverse? Assume the first column B to be B11, B12, okay, first column, that's a column, B13, and so on. Okay, inverse. Using this in the definition of matrix multiplication, okay, first column of B, column, we're talking of column. So first column of B, because that is inverse, that is B11, B21, up to BN1, okay, which is equal to 1, the vector 1, then the rest of the elements of the vector are zeros. What about the second column B? That is B12, B22, and so on up to BN2. And since this is a second column, 0, 1, and the rest are 0. Okay? The remaining columns in B can be found in the same manner. Okay, so just look at this pattern, and then we can immediately do the rest of the remaining columns in B. Okay. Example, actual example, we have inverse of a matrix. Find the inverse of a square matrix A. Okay. We have the same matrix A using the decomposition procedure, the L and U matrices are found to be. Okay, so already determine this lower and the upper triangular matrices in the previous example. So we have these values. Solving for each column of B requires two steps. What are those? Number one, solve lower triangular matrix times Z is equal to C. Solve this for Z. And then number two, solve upper triangular matrix times vector x variable is equal to z, and solving this for x. So this looks familiar because this forms part of the second and third steps of LU decomposition. Okay, so step one here. So we have to find out Z, that is the first step here, find out Z. We have a lower triangular matrix, and it is very easy to find this out because we have an equation here. Let us just substitute. We can obviously find the value of Z1 here because Z1 is equal to 1, so Z1 is equal to 1. We already know the value of Z1, so we have what? 2.56, 1, Z2 is equal to 0. So therefore, we can obviously solve Z2 because we already know the value of Z1, which is equal to 1. So Z2 is equal to negative 2.56. And we can already solve for Z3 because we already know Z1 and Z2. And therefore, you can just transfer these two terms to the other side and solve for Z3. So Z1 is equal to 1 and Z2 is equal to 2.56. So 2.56 times 3.5 and then plus 5.76. Whatever this sum total of these two, put the negative sign because it will go to the other side of the equation. That is the value of Z3. So we can immediately solve for this. So these are the values. These are the values. Using that simple algebraic manipulation. So we have our vector solution for Z vector. So 1, negative 2.56, and 3.2. Okay. So next step is to solve for the variable vector x. Okay. So vector x. Okay. So we have what? So instead of vector x, it use the what? The variable b, 1, 1, b, 2, 1, and b, 3, 1. Okay? Instead of variable x. That is supposed to be x1, x2, x3. Okay, okay, so this is our vector z, which was solved in the previous page. Okay? So doing that, it is also a simple matter that is only back substitution because we have the upper triangular matrix already multiplied by the variable vector. We can solve all the values for the variable vector because we have the triangular matrix already. Backward, back substitution. So doing the back substitution, we can find the value for the variable, actually x, variable x. This has a typo error here. This is supposed to be x1, x2, x3. Okay. So doing that, we have the value for x. Okay. So using back substitution. Okay, so we have the following vector. Okay, so because we have the one x here, big x, so we have x supposed to be. Okay, anyway, so this are the first column of the inverse of A. So this is a first column because we are solving for the first column, that's why it is called B because inverse of A is. Matrix B. That is the only reason. Okay, so repeating for the second and third columns of the inverse, doing the same process, meaning to say, so we can have the second column to be equal to this and the third column to be. You have to verify this by doing it manually using your scratch paper as an assignment, as a practice problem solving. Okay, so second column. And third column. So this is what? Combination of what? Row column. How to do it? So for example, this one. This element is equal to what? Negative 0.4643. Which is what? The element row 2, third column. Okay? Row 2, third column. So after which we have three. Column, first, second, and third column, we can now form the matrix. Okay, so we can now form the matrix. So we can form the matrix here, supposed to be. Okay, let us form the matrix. It was not given here. It is supposed to be matrix. what's the new matrix type? So we cannot do it. So just, these are the columns. So just use this column to look like a matrix. Can we do it? Can we do it like this? Cannot do it. Anyway, that supposed to look like a matrix with three columns we're able to find. So just form the matrix that is called matrix B, which is an inverse of matrix A. Again, that's all for this example, and see you next video. This is Dr. Epi, preaching engineer.